Hello everyone, this is DC modular servo system experiment. So in this experiment we are going to learn how to control a DC motor with some electronic component. The electronic component present here, first this one is operational amplifier. So this component is called pre-amplifier, and this component is called attenuator unit, where two numbers of potentiometer is connected here, and this is the DC motor which we are going to control with these components. And we have another potentiometer, this is called input potentiometer, and this is the output potentiometer. And this is the brake, eddy current brake. So this is magnetic disc, this is the DC motor, and this is the motor shaft. That motor shaft is connected to one disc. Okay, this is disc, metallic aluminium metallic disc, and this is the one coupling. And that coupling, one shaft is connected to this reduction gear TECO unit. Okay, this is nothing but a TECO generator. This is TECO generator. The TECO generator is connected with output potentiometer through this shaft. Okay, and this is the power amplifier, sorry, this is the power supply from where we are getting the required DC power, DC voltage, positive 15 or minus 15 to our DC motor. This is the servo amplifier from where motor is getting the power. From power supply, it is power going to this servo amplifier, then servo amplifier one cable is internally connected to this DC motor. So these are the components. So we have total 5 experiments we have set here. So within that 5 experiment, already some pre-built circuit is given to you. According to that given diagram, I have already made that circuit and collected some setup data for each experiment. From that data, you need to do your calculation or make your plot your graph accordingly. Okay, let's move to the experiment now. So in this experiment, we are going to use this one attenuator unit and one pre-amplifier. And one this is one power supply. Okay, so already in the manual the circuit is given, so I am going to show you the circuit. What is the circuit? So circuit is I am making here. So one by one, this type of wire you need to plug. First we going to start from attenuator unit. One electrical lead already, one end is connected. Second end you need to connect in a pre-amplifier. So finally this is the circuit. Okay, so in this experiment you are basically going to learn about the operating characteristics of this pre-amplifier. Okay, this is the pre-amplifier, 1 minute. So this pre-amplifier, this 1 minute. Okay, this pre-amplifier, you want to, what are the characteristics? Means if you give some particular input from this electrical lead to, or some these wires if you connect there, then what will be the response in the output side? Say if you're giving some particular voltage, 1 volt or 2 volt here, then output what voltage will come out? That can, from that you need to find out the characteristics of this pre-amplifier. Okay, so after that, what you need to do, you need to measure the voltage from this output ports from here, this 8 and 9. it is marked at for this 3 or for this 9, no, sorry, for this 3 and 4. Okay, 1 minute. So this will be the V3 and this will be the V4. Okay, so in V3 now I am going to take the output voltage. So this is V3 voltage. So 5.31 something is set by this attenuometer unit. If you increase the attenuometer unit from here, voltage will increase and decrease in the voltage will increase and decrease in your output of your this preamplifier. This is our V3 voltage is shown here, 3.3 volt. If you adjust this one, the upper potentiometer, then you can get a course increase, say 1 volt or 0.5 volt, it will suddenly increase. If you want to increase precisely, then you can use this second potentiometer to 0.1 or 0.2, like that type of decimal, point decimal. If you want to increase, then you can increase to this potentiometer. Okay, so this is the experiment. Okay, now you need to take the voltage of V4, second output point, this one V4, and the same way you need to set the various position of these two potentiometer, and you need to take some readings. Okay, so particular setting of that potentiometer, you need to take various readings from, say you start from position 1 on this potentiometer. 1 minute. So some positions are there. If you rotate this one, the 10 position, 1 to 10 some positions are there. Here also some positions are there. You need to start from 1 and you need to take the corresponding output voltage reading of V3 or V4, and if you need to move the for second reading, you need to move the this potentiometer to position 2, and you need to take the corresponding output voltage of that position 2 potentiometer with okay. So like that way you need to take several several position and several output volt you will get from the preamplifier. Okay, from that you need to find out the characteristics of this preamplifier. Okay, I mean what input volt you are provided and what will be the output it will gain from this preamplifier. This is the experiment. Okay, so in this experiment we are providing the data sheet for calculation. This is experiment number 2 of a DC modular servo system. In this experiment, we are using these components. This is number 1 attenuometer unit, and number 2 this is a servo amplifier, number 3 this is DC power source or power supply, and 1 operational amplifier, and this is a DC motor, and this is the TECO generator or reduction gear or TECO unit. Okay, this is a display monitor number 7 where you can display the RPM. Okay, so in this experiment the measure points are from here. From this point you can measure the error volt. Okay, and from here, from this point, you can find the reference volt. Okay, and from here, from this line, you can find the TECO generator voltage. Okay, these three voltages you need to find out, and speed or corresponding RPM to corresponding voltage, that RPM you can find out here in this display monitor. Okay, it is in terms of RPM, revolution per minute. So let's start the video. Already I made the connection. So it is doing like this. By using the multimeter, you can get the corresponding readings, and from here you can get the RPM of the particular voltage setting. For that particular voltage setting, you can get particular this deco generator volt here in this multimeter. You can adjust the generator unit from here, and you can switch to different voltage. Okay, this is the RPM again for particular voltage setting. For the experiment number 2, this is the data. These are the data set. So this data set you can get from the circuit. You need to connect the different points where I already shown where you can get reference voltage, deco generator voltage and error volt and speed and RPM. So these are the already we taken from one pre-recorded data. From this data, you need to plot the graph of error voltage versus speed of the DC motor. Okay, so you need to correlate between the what are the error volt according to various speed. Okay, so this is the end of the experiment number 2. Let's move to experiment number 3. This is experiment number 3. So in this experiment, we are using, these are the components we are using here. So this is servo amplifier, and this is power supply, this is operational amplifier, this is attenuator unit, and this is one deco generator, gear reduction unit, and this is the eddy current brake we are using with this output shaft, which is one aluminum disc is rotating here. We are obstructing, providing load by applying this brake, magnetic brake, you can also call as eddy current brake. And this is the DC motor. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram. So I am going to show a video on how to take the readings. You need to make the circuit diagram accordingly shown in this figure. Also, we are providing the manual. With this, you can get a clear idea on by read that manual. So I want to show from this error volt. These are data you need to collect. From error volt you can get the putting multimeter probe here, and common volt you can put here of the multimeter, and positive volt you can put here, then you can get the error volt. And reference volt you can get from this attenuator unit by putting power line, power terminal of the multimeter in this, now in this port, and here you can get a reference voltage. Like that, you can get deco generator volt by putting multimeter probe here. Also, you can measure by switching this knob, and here in this display monitor also you can measure the deco generator volt and RPM here by switching this lever. Once if you make it left side, it will show voltage, and if you put it right side, then it will show the RPM of the revolving shaft. Okay, and in this eddy current braking unit, the different brake level is there, 1 to 10, 0 to 10, and you can adjust different brake position level accordingly. Load will be vary in this DC motor. Okay, so this is the circuit. Okay, this is the video I already made it for you. So I am measuring here this error for time measuring here. From here, if you switch on the power supply, you can get a 0 volt. If you increase the voltage from input voltage from the potential unit, accordingly, 0 volt key. Okay. Okay, now I am going to measure the return voltage from the attenuator unit. So from here we can measure this reference volt from your multimeter. This is positive terminal I am going to connect here, and negative terminal I am connected to the ground of the system. So I am going to change this terminal to another one. Now I am connected. So these are the reference voltage you can get from this attenuator unit. Okay. So according to different conditions, you can get different reference voltage. So here I am going to show how to apply the brake with this eddy current magnet. So continuing the experiment, this is the RP unit. If you apply brake in the motor, when the RP will be pulled down, you can further increase the load. So RP will be decreased more. So these are the different brake settings accordingly. The speed will reduce accordingly. So from here we can measure the error voltage. Okay. The error voltage we can measure from here. By adjusting the potential meter, you can get different readings. Okay, this is the data set of experiment number 3 of different brake position. We get reference, this is a set of reference voltage, and these are the echo generator volt, these are the error volt, and these are the speed from corresponding brake setting, and these are the readings. Okay. So from this table you need to find this plot. You need to do plot a graph of error voltage versus brake position, and plot a graph of speed versus brake position. Okay, for the last experiment, one more is remaining. So I am going to show this. So this is the last experiment. In this experiment we are going to use servo amplifier. Okay. These are the components like previous one. This is the power supply, this is servo amplifier, this is the attenuator unit, this is the pre-amplifier, this is the DC motor, this is the eddy current brake, and this is the echo generator unit, where this is the display monitor of displaying the RPM and corresponding voltage. Okay, so in this experiment we are going to set about 1000 RPM speed of this DC motor. 1000 RPM we are going to set. Okay, 1000 RPM we are going to set, and that RPM we can do certain reference voltage. From the reference voltage we are rotating our motor, one is a forward direction, another reverse direction. For forward direction we are giving certain amount of certain reference voltage, and for reverse direction we give a certain amount of reverse voltage. That minimum, what minimum voltage is required to reverse and forward motion, this is already we taken from that. We make a circuit and taken out from data from the circuit. This is the minimum voltage required for the forward, means clockwise rotation of the motor. And this is the reference voltage for reverse direction of the motor. After making the circuit, from here, from this line, you can get reference voltage of different potentiometer setting, and you can get the error valve from here, and corresponding RPM you can get from here. That echo generator voltage also you can get from here. From all those these data, you need to do some calculations. So from we are providing on data sheet here. So we are applying brake also, eddy current brake at different braking position with certain reference. We are fixing the reference voltage at for forward motion 2.72, which is give you speed about 1000. Accordingly, if you increase the load, the RPM will be decreasing. So RPM will be decreasing here, this one for forward motion, and this is for reverse motion, anti-clockwise motion of your motor. So from this data sheet, we need to you need to do this plot graph of echo generator voltage versus error volt, and plot a graph of error volt versus speed for forward rotation. For reverse rotation, you need to plot these graphs. Okay, echo generator volt versus error volt. Then a graph error volt versus speed. Okay, so this is the end of this experiment. So I'm not going to show the video demonstration of this last experiment because it is same of like previous three experiment. So end of the experiment, you need to write after making this those draft for all experiment. At the end, you need to write few application of open and closed loop control system of DC motor according to your own word. Thank you.